In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may glory in the feast of the Blessed Apostle Thomas, so that we may always be sustained by his intercession, and believing may have life in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, whom Thomas acknowledged as the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him, the whole structure is held together and grows into a temple sacred in the Lord. In him, you also are being built together into a dwelling place of God in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify Him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast in His kindness for us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But Thomas said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hands into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen me and have believed." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. Today, we celebrate the Feast of St. Thomas, ang kapistahan ni San Tomas, Santo Tomas. Have you ever experienced putting your trust into someone, but then that person failed you? Naranasan mo na ba yan? Ibinigay mo lahat ng iyong tiwala sa isang tao, pero sa huli, wala ding kwenta. Iniwan ka din niya. If your answer is yes, then you can relate to what St. Thomas felt. Dahil akala ni Tomas, ganun yung nangyari sa kanya. You know, we have known Thomas as the doubting Thomas. Pero hindi naman talaga laging ganun si Tomas. Ang totoo niyan, isa si Tomas sa may pinakamalalim na pananampalataya among the apostles. May pagkakataon pa nga na ready na talaga siyang mamatay kasama ng ating Panginoon. Ibinigay niya ang lahat ng kanyang tiwala at pananampalataya sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo. Pero noong mga panahon na yon, hindi niya pa naiintindihan kung ano ang pagiging Mesaya. So was Thomas did not understand yet what it means to be a Mesaya. Hindi niya alam na kailangang magbata ng paghihirap ang Mesiyas. And so, nung namatay ang ating Panginoong Hesukristo sa krus, halos kasamang namatay doon yung pananampalataya ni Tomas. He was so disappointed. Kaya nga siguro, nung unang dumating ang ating Panginoon at nagpakita sa kanyang mga alagad, Tomas was not there. Pero after a week, nakita ni Tomas ang ating Panginoon. At ano yung naging expression niya? Ano yung sinabi niya? He expressed one of the deepest expressions of faith, "My Lord and my God." Sabi nung iba, isa itong pagkagulat lang. Kumbaga na sabi niya lang, "Oh my God." But no, in the whole New Testament, only Thomas addressed Jesus as God. Siya lang yung tumawag kay Jesus na Diyos. And ito yung pinakamalalim na paglalahad ng pananampalataya sa ating Panginoon. But what can we learn from Thomas? Unang-una, we can learn from his mistake. Matuto tayo sa pagkakamali ni Thomas. Ano ba yung naging pagkakamali niya? Sa gitna ng kanyang pagdududa at disappointment, anong ginawa niya? Umalis siya. Nagpakalayo siya. Hindi siya nanatili doon sa community of believers. At pag ang isang disipulo ay sumusunod sa ating Panginoong Hesukristo, ang isang disipulo ay laging dapat nasa tabi ng kanyang Panginoon. At tayo bilang Kristiyano, bilang tagasunod ng ating Panginoon, we should always be beside our Lord. Huwag tayong lalayo sa ating Panginoon. Huwag tayong lalayo sa ating Panginoon. Kumapit tayo sa Kanya. Now, it speaks about us. Ano bang sinasabi nito tungkol sa atin? Na kung tatanungin natin yung ating sarili, every time we have disappointment, every time we have crisis sa ating buhay, kanino tayo pumupunta? Lumalayo ba tayo sa Diyos o mas lalo tayong lumalapit? Yung iba kasi sa atin, every time they encounter a crisis, the tendency is lumayo sa Diyos. At saan pumupunta? Minsan sa alak. Minsan sa paglalasing. And minsan sa droga. Minsan sa sugalan. Minsan sa kung saan-saan. But the experience of Thomas reminds us to stay close to Jesus no matter what. At kung tayo ay makaranas man ng disappointment and doubt sa ating buhay, the more we have to get closer to the Lord. Although hindi naman laging madali yun. Stay beside the Lord. Pangalawa, we can learn from Thomas na hindi naman lahat ng oras masama magduda. Hindi naman lahat ng oras masama mag-alinlangan. Not all the time, doubting is evil. Kasi sa totoo lang, no, dahil sa pagdududa, mas nakakarating tayo sa mas malalim na pananampalataya. It is through the doubt of Thomas that he came to believe Jesus more. Mas sumalim yung pananampalataya ni Tomas nung nakita niya si Jesus. Dahil nung unang dumating ang ating Panginoon at wala siya doon, sinabi ng mga disipulo, nakita nila si Jesus, pero hindi siya naniwala. Hindi siya naniwala na dumating ang ating Panginoon. But then, nung nakita niya uli ang ating Panginoon, yung kanyang pagdududa ay napalitan ng mas malalim at mas malakas na pananampalataya. Yung pagdududa at pag-aalinlangan ay hindi naman masama. Ang masama ay yung tuluyan tayong mawalan ng pananampalataya. But sometimes, in our lives, our doubts may lead us to deeper sense of faith. At panghuli, tayo hindi na natin nakikita face to face ang ating Panginoon. Unlike Thomas, he encountered Jesus face to face. Pero tayo hindi na natin nakikita ang ating Panginoon. At least, hindi pa sa panahon na to. But every time we look, or every time we look at the image of Jesus, we see Jesus. And every time we receive Him in the Eucharist, we encounter Jesus. At kung ano yung sinabi ng ating Panginoon kay Tomas, ganun din naman yung sinasabi niya sa atin. Believe. Do not be unbelieving. At sinasabi niya rin sa atin, blessed are those who have not seen me and have believed. My dear brothers and sisters, our faith may be wounded by unbelief. But let us allow Jesus, let us allow the wounds of Jesus to heal our unbelief. And let us hold on to His words, blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Amen.
Please stand.
With faith in the risen Christ, whose wounds are the signs of His victory, let us bring our intentions to the Father of mercies. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a church, we may not be wanting in manifesting our faith to unbelieving people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That there may be growth in the Church of Asia, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That hardened sinners and unbelievers may overcome their doubt and embrace the true faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are overburdened with life, especially the lonely and the sick, may experience the joy of Christ's resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may share in the glory of everlasting life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, as we make our intercessions, deepen our faith, that like St. Thomas, we may love and adore your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
We render you, O Lord, the service that is your due, humbly imploring you to keep safe your gifts in us, as we honor the confession of the Apostle St. Thomas and offer you a sacrifice of praise. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You indeed are holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Walang hanggan.
kagalakan sa nalulumbay, katarungan sa nalapit, at kanungan ng bayan mong sawi.
Please stand.
Let us pray. O God, as we truly receive in this sacrament the body of your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that we may recognize him with the Apostle Thomas by faith as our Lord and our God, and proclaim him by our deeds and by our life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
Announcement. Our Wednesday Family Rosary tonight at 9 p.m. will be prayed by the Filipino community of the Basilica de Santo Stefano Maggiore in Milan, Italy. Let us together gather as a family and as a community to pray and ask the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Like, follow, and share this good news to all. Second, join and witness the visit of the original and canonically crowned image of the Virgin of Consolation and Cincture, venerated in San Agustin Church in Intramuros, to the Manila Cathedral. The welcome rites will be on July 6, 2024, that's on Saturday, at 11:30 in the morning. The farewell Mass will be on July 13, 2024, at 7:30 a.m., and will be presided by Father Edwin Hari, OSA, Rector of the Archdiocesan Shrine of Nuestra Señora de la Consolación y Corella, Intramuros, Manila. Please all stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the Lord bless and keep you now and forever.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, ito.